Linda Nolan here. She's an interior designer. How are you?
I'm great, thanks.
Welcome to the program.
Yes, thank you very much.
Good to have you here. I can't believe, have you never been on our show before?
Yes, I have, years ago.
Years ago, yeah, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought so.
Yeah, and then I did a design segment for about 4 years.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah.
You've been at interior design for, a long time here in the nation's capital.
39 years, Kurt.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. And we were just talking about how, you know, at this point in your career, maybe thought you'd be slowing down. That's not happening.
And no, if anything, it's just crazy. Absolutely crazy.
You're one of those, I want to show off a couple of your projects. We'll get to them shortly. But you're one of those people, like top to bottom, if I want renovations done, you design it, you have a crew to do it, you finish it.
That's right. A complete turnkey. So everything from the design concept to all of the implementation, all the way through.
So when I hire you, I have nothing to worry about except walking into my new space.
That's right.
We're going to do a couple of little things today. I know you love the blackboard painting,
mm-hmm.
and this is an example of what you can do.
Yeah.
So you take just a piece of wood and you painted it, that's it?
Yeah, here's the blackboard paint right here, and price on it's like $24.95, so for a great do-it-yourself project, this is something that you can do not just in a kid's room.
No.
Or a playroom, but you can do it in your kitchen. So I just did a model home recently.
And you did a whole wall?
I did a whole wall in blackboard paint, and it's for menus. And so you can write your daily menu
you
on it, your
on.
Grocery list, doodle if you want, but it's absolutely beautiful.
Yeah, and it's great for this time of year with kids, and they're going to that place where they learn soon. Mm. I don't like to say the word in August, but...
That's right.
it works out, to-do lists, homework, all that
sort of
thing.
And this is something fun that the kids can help with
they can
also.
Help, yeah.
Give them a paintbrush and let them go to town. And so this is really fun.
Yeah, it feels just like it, eh? I never knew how they did that, but they make the paint to do it. These kind of projects I love. And this actually came from your place.
Yeah, this is from my house. So the reclaimed furniture movement is huge right now.
Yeah.
So here's a beautiful... Actually, this is a piece of reproduction furniture, but you could take any piece of furniture.
The old furniture is so solid and good.
Yeah.
All you need to do is sand it down and decide what color you want to stain it or paint it, right?
That's right. And then you buy this. This is milk paint. And again, it's, the price isn't on it, but it's probably about $15. And by the way, milk paint. So I'll tell you where you can get the chalk paint and milk paint is at Bonds Decor. They have both of them there.
Okay.
And you can also get unfinished furniture there.
Right.
So then you just take your milk paint, different colors, some blues, a bit of yellow, a bit of cream.
Yeah.
Just paint it on, get some sandpaper,
and
then just rub it off.
And you antique it yourself.
You antique it, and you know what? It's so simple, and you end up with a beautiful piece of furniture like this.
Or you can sand the whole thing down and restain it and or repaint it and make it look like brand new, but it'd be solid good, right?
You could also do it, for instance, let's say in a solid blue milk paint.
Yeah.
And then just sand off some edges. And you get a beautiful
that
antique.
That old kind of look.
That old look. It's absolutely beautiful.
I want to show you a couple of pictures that you sent us that we were going to... there we go.
Okay.
So what's that now?
That is... Okay, let's talk about upholstering a headboard.
Now, two pieces of wood and some plywood, correct?
That's a piece of plywood. That's right, which you're going to get at Rona, Home Depot, wherever.
Right.
And then this is the finished product, because what you're going to do to that plywood is then get a piece of foam.
Yep.
And you're going to staple that foam on, then buy a piece of fabric.
Which is what you did in the picture and also what you did right here, correct?
And then you wrap the fabric over and you can buy... Now, in the picture, you see there's stainless steel nail heads. You can buy those at upholstery stores. All of the materials I got at Rockland Textiles, because they have every single thing there that you need, including the nail heads and the piping.
Yeah.
And here's an example of a finished upholstered
headboard. Very small bed.
yes. yeah, okay, and this is a very hot
there's
item.
There's the foam, right?
Yeah, there's the foam.
There's
on the
backing.
Yeah.
And the backing's stapled on once you get this. How do you get the ridges, the edges, and this detail in here?
Well, this
Linda?
Is piping that you buy. Well, you just staple it down here behind. And actually, you can find all of the instructions online.
Oh, really?
So, yeah. So if you just go for do-it-yourself headboards, all of the instructions and
place.
Pictures, they're all
and,
online.
And the upholstered headboard is a cool thing these days?
It is a huge
item. It's an accent for your room, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is, and it's also very soft and comfy. But not only that, but you can make this curt for under $200. They sell in the stores, usually starting at about $850.
Yeah.
So this is, it's a huge saving, and you get, depending upon the fabric that you buy, the fabric is probably the most expensive item, but you can buy fabric for $10 a yard.
Yeah. So listen, we got to run. We could talk all day, but these are just a couple of things you like to point out to people. Your website is available for information on how to get in touch with you and other ideas, right?
Yeah, www.lindanolaninteriors.com.
Linda, nice to have you here.
Thank you, Kurt.
Thanks for coming by.
Thank you.
I love the chalkboard paint.